This week's video, like all my videos, are community sponsored, so I'd like to thank Big Perm 586, it says on my teleprompter, for sending this resource in, as well as two other books. This is number 2 of 3 in the sets that he sent me to review. Just want to say a big thank you and shout out to you, man. I really appreciate you. Because of you, the community gets to be a little bit smarter this week. All right, let's jump into that sweet, sweet new intro. What's going on, everybody? My name is Chad, of course, and this week I was real tempted to make this like almost a 40-minute video. Frankly, so this is book number 2 that Big Perm sent us. This is Shadowing, Let's Speak Japanese. And the reason I wanted to make this so long wasn't because I wanted to film myself shadowing or show you guys my process, the behind the scenes. That's between me, a hot tub, and a bag of beets. However, I have many reservations about so many of the claims that people who swear by shadowing say. Just personal preference, I'm wrong all the time. Maybe I'm wrong here, it happens. But I have many heavy reservations. It's weighty, like when you let a fat Greek man sleep on you in the midsummer sun. So I started going through this and I started writing my script and I started looking at my word count and my sentence count and all the stuff that I normally do for these videos. And it turned out that this was probably gonna be 20 minutes just on the things I wanted to talk about specifically with shadowing before I got to the book. Now I'm sure you in the future, I don't even know this for sure, you're seeing how long this video already is. Imagine adding like 20 extra minutes for me to complain about this. So I decided, to be concise and clear, I will save, okay, save, push it off to the future. I decided to leave this guy completely out of that. I will save my critiques for later, specifically with shadowing. I just want to review the resource here. So if you guys enjoy shadowing, if you're watching this, whether you know me or not, and you're like, Chad, you're dumb. I think shadowing works. I want to do shadowing. That's totally fine. I am not here to tell you any which way for you to study or learn, however you guys want to do. Lord knows I have made vastly more mistakes in my language learning journey than you guys probably ever will. But I do want to give you guys kind of a hands-on look at this book if you're into shadowing, to see if maybe this is a resource for you, or maybe you don't know much about shadowing and you kind of want to see if maybe there's like a resource about it that you might want to do. I won't go necessarily into depth about shadowing, but since this book is all about that, it even has it here in large letters, then maybe it might be something for you to check out. Regardless, stick around, check out my hands-on review, and stay for the subscriber-only outro, because I have a special outro only if you're subscribed, and if you're not subscribed, they're coming for you. So yeah, let's run over to the hands-on table. Of course, this room is not fitting enough for such a handsy maneuver as going through a textbook, so let's roll over to there, and I will see you guys at the outro. Yeet! Alrighty, everybody, welcome to the hands-on review. This is Shadowing, Let's Speak Japanese. Again, I'm gonna try and leave as much of my baggage at the back door, shall we say. And not the fun back door, not the Uncle Jerry back door, just the back door of my mind, so that way, whenever I feel like screaming, I can just kick those thoughts away. Just kick them away. So, this is Shadowing, Let's Speak Japanese. I will say there's a couple things I do want to start off with, just so everyone knows. This is a 2-book series. This is the beginner to intermediate series, and from my very brief research into the rest of these books, there appears to be another one that is intermediate to advanced. I don't have that book. I was sent this book, so we're gonna get real handsy with the beginner to intermediate version. On top of that, this book does include 3 versions of explanations. You have English, Chinese, and Korean, as well as the original Japanese, and I'll just show you that real quickly here because I won't go into that into the rest of this review. Just so that way you guys can see, you have English, that's Chinese, and Korean, I presume, as well as the original Japanese. Now, beyond all that, I will also say, definitely more of a self-study type of book. Not that you can't use this in a classroom. If you're planning on doing shadowing as like a teacher, not that this is bad, it just, this tends to be more leaned towards the self-studier, as well as, let's talk a bit about the price here. I'm sure you guys can see that. That's about $14, that's about 1400 yen-ish. Plus tax. However, if you're gonna buy this overseas, most of the time it's around 20-ish bucks. So, again, I gotta put my own biases aside. What do you get for $14? Or I guess 20 if you're overseas. Well, the very first thing is you get this here CD, which you guys know what I usually do with these. And as a joke, I would normally throw them away, right? I would toss this off screen because this means less to me than physical trash. Because all these CDs are good for, normally with me, is they just take up room in my garbage can. However, I'm reviewing this book for somebody. I'm trying to be polite about this. I'm not gonna toss this. Also, the totality of this book relies on this, so you can't toss this even if you wanted to. That being said, and I'm sure I've talked to you guys plenty about this, I have no CD player. I have tried to find one. My Mac doesn't have one. Nothing I own has one. Nothing in my house has one. I have a DVD player, but it doesn't play CDs. I had to call my pops and ask to get in his car and use his CD player to actually get a taste for that and to go through the book in his car in June in the summer heat. So that was delightful. On top of that, just to give you guys a bit of a feel, actually, before I even go any deeper, let me give my normal disclaimer. I'm only gonna show you the parts of this book that are 100% necessary to give what I would call an accurate critique of the book, for you guys, to hopefully let you guys know what you're gonna expect if you get into this book, what's kind of the format like. I'm not trying to show you the whole book. You're not gonna see the whole book. Honestly, if you guys find that this book seems like something that you would wanna buy, please, please, please go buy it. Support the people who put the time in to make this book. Now that that's all said and done, let's see what type of content we're looking at here. We have the contents here, and just so you guys know about how this is separated or how it's organized before we keep going forward, you should be able to see this little binger bopper here. This should tell you how this works. There's essentially units. Units are like chapters. There's 5 total units. Each unit has sections that composite it. So you can see here, this is unit 1, yeah, and it has 10 sections. All of them have roughly that. You have 10 sections, 9 sections, 8 sections, for a total of 5 units. Now, you might be asking yourself, Chad, how much content is that? Well, I have absolutely no life. So I actually went and counted how many individual pieces you guys are gonna get inside this book. I'm sure you guys can see, but this is one, so you have like konnichiwa, konnichiwa, just simple kind of basic stuff all the way down. So I counted each one of these, so that way hopefully you guys are gonna be able to know what you can expect. Each line has basically one line and then a response. The whole book is the same format all the way to the end. It's 2 pieces of dialogue each, except for back here where it kind of goes back and forth a little bit. There is 411 pieces of dialogue, which I will say, to my surprise, that is more than I had anticipated the book to have. I expected the book to be maybe 70, 80 pieces for the price, for the size of the book. So that is more dense than I will admit that I expected. That was actually a surprise for me. But as you can see, all the individual pieces are more or less one back and forth. Sometimes you'll get more than one back and forth. So yeah, 411 instances, that's pretty good. One thing I will say, pay attention to. A lot of people skip these intro sections here, and most of my audience speaks English. I'll probably do the English section just so you guys kind of can see what I'm talking about, hopefully. The thing that I want you guys to think about, and it's something you really do have to think about, because even if, you know, shadowing's the way to go, and even if, you know, you like this book, I want you guys to know the type, or at least the understanding of the people that made this book. If you check out over here, let's take a look. They actually have a JLPT equivalent right here. This is Level of Japanese Language Proficiency Test, and you have 4, 3, that's N2, guys. This is the JLPT N2. Let's talk a bit about what it says the top of what they're using that is N2 is. Well, the very first thing is it should be over 650 hours. The over is the only saving grace of this number, and I'll go into that in a moment. The other thing, if you could see here, what are the vocabulary and grammar examples that it is attributing to N2? You see your causative passive forms, honorific and humble language, proverbs, expressions about computers, etc. Now you might be saying to yourself, Chad, what's the big deal about that? Well, I would like to show you, this is my Genki 2. This is my actual Genki 2 that I, ooh, there's a string in the way. That's gonna drive me nuts when I'm editing this. All right, so this is my actual N2, or my Genki 2. You can see, wow, look how creative I am, special, and I'm such a snowflake. So that book claims that causative passive is N2. I would like to turn your guys' attention to tab or chapter 23 here. Oh, looky here, Herschel. What's all this then, Sean? Could it be the causative passive form of verbs at the end of the Genki 2 book? What? It is also talking about humble language. Which, let's talk about that. We have here, chapter 19. Oh, what? What's this? Honorific verbs? Are you kidding me? respectful advice in chapter 20? Can we talk about extra modest here for a moment, boys? Humble expressions? Yeah, guys, this is Genki 2. Now, why does this matter? What does this have to do with that approach? I'm sure a lot of you guys have used the Genki books. There's plenty of people that have. I don't know if you could see, even up here, beginner level Japanese, right? Because that's what this is. I don't know about you guys. I did not feel even in the ballpark of what the JLPT N2 is in this book. Even finishing this book, because that's the last chapter, is causative passive forms. So I'm sure I'll just let you guys decide that for yourself. I don't even have to make a declarative statement. For all of you who have used this book, when you finished, did you feel that that was N2 level at all? Any of what I just talked about? Or would you agree with the people that make books like these, that this is pretty beginner, this is pretty elementary, as they say in giant, bold letters, Japanese? And these guys are claiming that that's N2. Truth of the matter is, everything that's in this book, it's all beginner. There's no intermediate by anyone's definition, certainly not N2. Anyone that's been in the Genki books probably would say, I mean, me personally at least, when you finish both Genki books, you're probably very, you know, very set for the N5, and you have about an incomplete or a half-done N4 level understanding of the language. Definitely not the N2. Not in grammar, not in vocab, not in kanji, not even in listening. And if you look at the very back of this book in Unit 5, nothing in here is the level of stuff you hear on the listening section. They're already off to a bad start as far as I'm concerned. The second thing I want you guys to look at is the hours. Same issue that I have. If you're saying it's 650, let's talk about bare minimums just from Chad, just from me. I just passed the N2 and pretty much barely, right? I got a 96, so 6 points above failing. I guess 7 points above failing. Let's do some math. So, bare minimum, by the way, when I was studying, the hardest that I've ever studied, I was doing quite a bit more than this, but we're saying a minimum, pretty much. About 4 hours a day, 5 days a week. I'm doing about 20 hours of Japanese a week. That's a bare minimum. I was doing closer to 8 to 10 hours, especially when I was in Japan, or when YouTube was hella baller before the all that nonsense happened and I had to actually be an adult with PewDiePie. So regardless, let's just say as an average over the whole time, I had to do about 20 hours a week. There's about 52 weeks in a year because I don't take off weeks. That's about 1,000 hours in 1 year that I was doing bare minimum. And it took me 4 years to pass that test. That's 4,160 hours. Yeah, I don't like want to be mean, but so I get 400 to 650 for whatever, N3. I don't know if that's even true. To say over 650 is their only saving grace, because technically, yes, 4,000 is over 650. But my God, if you add up all these times, that's still half the time. If you did each one of these to the max and then added that time to the next one, that's still not even half of the hours of the minimum that I had to put in. Yeah, I mean, you can already see that if you're considering this intermediate at all, I mean, I guess everyone has their own definitions, but I would definitely not call this in any capacity intermediate. On top of that, I also don't really like shadowing. I think that if they are comparing this to a JLPT, they either have not taken it at all and are just lying, or I don't know. I don't know what the excuse would be that they think causative, passive, and honorific languages into. I don't know. And I usually try and attribute good to people. I mean, I don't think that these people are bad, right? I just don't know where on earth they could possibly be getting these numbers if they've ever held a JLPT N2 test, even if they glanced over one. You can get free ones online and print them out and just look at them and know that that's not what this is. Ugh, it's just frustrating. This book to me was very frustrating. However, that's also just me. If you like shadowing, this book might be great for you. Again, 411 instances isn't bad for 14 bucks or maybe even cheaper if you can get it used. Definitely not bad, I don't think. But if I could recommend anything to anybody, just find an anime that's easy that you like a Doraemon or something. Find fan Japanese subtitles online somewhere and just do it with that. That literally does the exact same thing as this, because you have the words being spoken. You can look at the subtitles before, which is what this book says to do, and then you can repeat it as fast as you hear Doraemon say it. It's literally the same thing, and it's free. It doesn't cost you any money. So I don't know. I don't like giving bad reviews, but this book is not doing it for me. But I don't know. Let's leave this up to you guys. Let's send this back to Studio Chad. Let's hear what you guys have to think. Alrighty, back in the studio, and I just want to ask you guys, what did you think of shadowing? Let's speak Japanese. I'm sure I mentioned this last week, but I've noticed lots of people share my reviews in just random corners of the internet, and I also know lots of people who might not even be fans of me read the comment section and try and see maybe there's like a consensus among people about what a resource is and which ones are good, and if this one sucks, maybe there's a bad one, or maybe this one's really good. But it's contentious and people want to give their opinions. There's a thousand different reasons why. If you would like to not only support me and my channel, but to maybe help someone 5-10 years from now who's seeing this video after I've been murdered by chimpanzees, to see if they want to start the Japanese journey that eventually led me to the wilderness of Zimbabwe, then leave a comment down below. Tell me what you think about this book, and I guess more broadly, right? Tell me what you think about shadowing. What do you guys think? Do you think it works? Do you think that this is the end-all be-all? Do you think it's garbage? Do you think it's like chiropractors claiming to cure cancer? What is it that you guys think about shadowing, and I guess in particular this book, because that really is what this video is about. Any and all of those, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, or compliments in general about me, my channel, my nice funny hat, you can leave them in the comment box down below. I do personally read all of them. If you guys would also like to support my channel for free, hit the like button. Any sort of engagement, like shares and likes and comments, tells YouTube, Big Daddy, holy algorithm, that my channel's worth sharing, that it's worth showing to people, and that all this hard work I put into these productions and in getting this stuff for you guys so you can be more educated tells YouTube that, hey, we should probably spread this around like a marmalade. But yeah, it's super simple, costs you guys nothing. If you would, however, if I've maybe added value to your life and you would like to support me, it is never required, but always, always welcome. My Patreon has the manga club in it, as well as postcard tiers and various other things that you guys can be a part of to support my channel, as well as to help you support your study. Manga club is less than $1 a day, and you'll get real Japanese manga shipped from the shelves of Japan to your front door every single month. Also, I have a rod company down below. You can check out that. That's zimkara.com. That's a rod company I run with my dad, and we essentially import Japanese, the specialty fly rods that they have there without the reels, the real cool things that are based on the bamboo. So I wanted to give that a quick shout out. The sun is out, it's bright and shiny, and since it's the Rona times, we all can't hang out together, right? So you want to be by yourself, alone, near a river in a gutter somewhere with a homeless person, and what better way to make friends with that homeless person than trading fish, or I don't know, maybe shoes. I don't know what homeless people really have by the river. Either way, check out that link, twitch.tv/ChadZimmerman. I stream on there as much as I possibly can. And yeah, I think that's really all I want to say. Again, big shout out to Big Perm. Thank you to Lana for making the intro. Now you guys are gonna see the outro that she offered to do, and just was like, hey, I already made you an intro. Would you like an outro to finish it off? And I was like, heck yeah, man. So let's roll the outro. Before I do that, love hard, love deep, and I'll see you all next week. And also at the subscriber only outro. Alrighty, so we're everyone's gone, just the subscribers, right? Alright, so thank you guys for watching. You clearly support me more than anyone else in this community because you subscribe, you care. You got big hearts and you got gout. And so I just want to say thank you so much for doing that. It means a lot. I got so much positive comments about doing these stupid outro bits that, yeah, they do technically hurt my analytics because people don't always watch all the way through now. But so what? I like doing these and I'm having fun and you guys apparently enjoy it. So I decided maybe to introduce you guys to my pup. I was going to introduce you to Sophie, maybe play a little fetch. And I don't know, maybe play some nice music. I don't know, something stupid. Something dumb just to be like, hey, thanks for being a sub. Here's a special video just for you guys. Sophie. Hey. Come on. Come here. Oh, Sophie. He's not.
Oh, my girl. Oh, my God. You're so fluffy and cute. Oh, you're so fluffy. Oh, my God. Oh, you're so good girl.
Oh, shoot. Oh,
Sophie. Oh. Ha ha ha.